When are YouTube hashtags, you know, those blue bits of writing that you're starting to see below everybody's videos, when are those not hashtags? When they're video locations. Confuzzled? Here's everything you need to know. Let's do this.
vidIQ.
vidIQ.
vidIQ.com.
Super quick summary then. YouTube hashtags are relatively new. If you're seeing up to three words, which is prefixed with a hashtag, those are the new feature that everybody is playing around with at the moment. And if you're playing around with them, do let us know in the voting card up here. Otherwise, if you're seeing general locations around the world, that's something that's been around on YouTube for a very long time. Then it disappeared for a little bit. Now it's coming back. How do we use them? Hello everyone, my name is Rob. Welcome to vidIQ. If this is your first time here, we are the YouTube tool and channel that aims to help you get more views in less time. Look right here. Yeah, it's free to download. Setting a location for your YouTube video is not new, but in recent months the option has vanished from where you would usually find it, in the advanced tab of your video editor or upload page. So where is it? The answer lies in the new Creator Studio beta. I know, it's not to everyone's taste, but for some inexplicable reason, if you want to set a video location, this is where you need to go. In the beta studio, click on the video tab and then click on the video you want to add a location to. There will be three tabs on this screen, and the tab you want is the advanced tab, where you will find location in the top right hand corner. As you start to type out a location, autocomplete suggestions will appear, and you can click on any of these to set the location of your video. The locations are tied to Google Maps, so you can use cities, countries, and even specific locations, such as shopping malls. What you can't do is put in fictional locations, unless they've been added to Google Maps. When we were playing around with hashtags, we added a fictional vidIQ location to Google Maps, and a week or so later, it started to appear as a location. As we've mentioned in previous videos, some inventive video creators were setting up locations called number one on trending, but Google seems to be removing these. You can also set a video location directly from your mobile device. For Android, within the YouTube application, go to your channel, then tap on videos, tap on the three dots next to the video you want to set a location for, and tap edit. Scroll down to the bottom and you should see the set location option right there. Same thing applies to the iOS version of YouTube. Go to your channel, your videos, three dots, edit, and scroll to the bottom to set your location. Okay, so you've just gone to the trouble of setting up a video location. The next question you might be asking is, why on earth did I do that? Put simply, video locations work exactly the same as hashtags. It's a clickable link above the title of your video, and it takes you onto a relevant YouTube search. So if you're covering a particular event in a particular location, it may be worth allowing your content to amalgamate with anything else on the subject. Perhaps the most important thing to remember about video locations is that they overwrite hashtags. So if you do put hashtags in your description, but also a video location, the video will take the location as a priority and you won't see the hashtags unless you put one in your title. So do remember that. In terms of things that can appear above your title, then we have YouTube hashtags, we have video locations, but there is one more thing to complete the set. And if you look at this video here from Tim Schmoyer, it looks like an enhanced version of a playlist with a season and episode number. And these are TV shows. It's not something that's readily available to all video creators. You don't unlock it after a certain number of subscribers, and it's only available to certain media accounts. So I just thought I'd make you aware of it, even though unfortunately most of us can't access it. With all that being said, are you using YouTube hashtags or YouTube video locations? We'd love to know your thoughts in the comments below. If you want to learn a lot more about the how-tos of YouTube hashtags, we have a wonderful tutorial here. And we also put together some strategies and what we've learned about YouTube hashtags in the very early weeks, right down there. Enjoy the rest of your video making day, and we'll see you on either of those two videos right now.